Ladies and gentlemen, may I call upon all our participants, our dear delegates who are sitting right at the back, could you please fill those seats right at the front? And we allow the latecomers to be seated right at the back. But we really appreciate you coming early, and we reserved all the VIP seats for you. So please come forward before we actually start our ceremony. Ai o te le iso ai a le loloto I le tutolo o sanganga ma le faleono le atinganga. E mō mōna o whapoipoi la au tu vanu. Whapoipoi li lia wha anofisao tupu nei le malaya o vavau. Mō whape ane. Pa pae ia I pahanga ti o le tautianga. Whingata o e Samoa. Whasonga o aom le atifolasa. Tu lou lava. O pa ia masao le tai ao le nei, e talitono o pa ia lava ia o atama ma ainga, ainga ma lato tama. E tu au ma le ala taua, ainga le tai ma le vaa fonti. Manatu o leo o poto I malai nei. Malai a fio ia lo sina, le ainga sa le valasi. O ia le falitolu ma le vaina le lepa, ia ale ma malu ia tui sa mau. Nunu watu la ia fatini o tau sala. Ina ne isala isa mātou upu. Ia ona failea malape o tau talanga. Sau o se taimi, na tō atu leo sau tū mtū pāla pala. E ala isa sau noanga, alana fionga, ile minister of sota inga. Ai mātou te whape atu, a whiwhio mai, susu mai, matala mai ao. Reverend Dr. Salisulu, Honorable Acting Prime Minister, Deputy Prime Minister, Honorable Ministers of Cabinet, Dignitaries, Your Excellencies, Fellow Speakers and Facilitators, Dear Participants from here and abroad, Development Partners, Business Community, NGOs, and of course our online viewers, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is indeed a great pleasure and honor to welcome each and every one of you to our first ever Together for a Digital Pacific Conference here in Samoa. A special warm welcome to our traveling delegates from the Pacific region, international speakers and facilitators from all corners of the globe. We are so honored to host you here in the beautiful Samoa, the only true paradise on earth, the heart of Polynesia. And in Samoa we say, ta lofa lava. E pe lava o tātou tū ma tātou wanga ma sani, e au lava ino tātou tā pātou li eli tā. Awe le tātou wha mua ili atua, ilo nā lofa mlo nā ngalelei. Ua wha tau no wina le tātou wha moe moe. Before we officially open this Digital Pacific Conference, we must rejoice and give thanks to our Heavenly Father for this wonderful day and ask for His blessing upon us all. I now call Reverend Dr. Siosi Salisulu to lead our gathering and deliberations for these 2 days in a word of prayer. Lausunga fafene.
Faftai lava. I'll speak English for everyone's convenience. And I would like to firstly say thank you to the Acting Prime Minister, Loa Fionga Afamasanga Le Puyai Riko Tupai, for the kind invitation to lead us in worship this morning. Let us worship God. May these words of my mouth and this meditation of my heart be pleasing into your sight, Lord, my God and my Redeemer. Amen. A conference in the Pacific that centers on a digital Pacific, it sounds like a paradox. Why would the Pacific, known for its natural serene beauty, pristine beaches, unspoiled fauna and flora, want anything to do with technology? People come to the Pacific to escape the maddened crowd and the trappings of the concrete metropolis that is all too familiar in the West. But we say no. Change has come. Positive and proactive change has come to the Pacific. We realize in the Pacifica that the traditions and culture of the Pacific can be enhanced. It can be further developed when we embrace the new digital era. But at the same time, we maintain the uniqueness and mana of the Pacifica. Access to the Pacific is now easier thanks to technology. We have apps, we have web pages showcasing us here in the Pacifica. This has allowed a generation to view our stories, our people, and our culture. Our treasured traditions are now able to be shared and disseminated with the help of the digital era. It is now a complementary tool and not a divisive one. I would like to read a verse from the Bible, from the Old Testament, the book of the prophet Nehemiah, chapter 2, verse 18, like this. I also told them about the gracious hand of my God on me and what the king had said to me. They replied, "Let us start building." So they began this good work. Most of us here would be familiar with this story from the Bible and the problem that Nehemiah faced. No one in 100 years would fix the wall or rebuild the wall at Jerusalem. When Nehemiah came along, he explained his vision for rebuilding the wall. He told the leaders of the city, but there was a tremendous amount of trepidation, of reluctance and apprehension. So Nehemiah prays and he meditates and he explains to those leaders, "Leaders, come, let us rebuild the wall, these great walls of Jerusalem." Judiciously, he encourages them, "This is not my project, but this is God's plan, that we build the wall." He didn't offer rewards, money, incentives, or a vacation at the Sea of Galilee. But he appeals to them as leaders. He appeals to their sense of nationalism. "Come, let us build the wall." And what is the response of the leaders? "Let us rise up and let us build." Brothers and sisters in Christ, when people are informed, we feel empowered. When people are educated about technology, we too in the Pacifica can answer with a united voice, "Let us rise up and build. Build a digital future, Mole Pacifica." Steve Jobs, co-founder of the Apple Incorporated, said, "It's not a faith in technology. It's faith in people that matter." I started with a Psalms and I will end with a Psalms. May my meditation be pleasing to him, for I rejoice in the Lord. Let us pray. Our Father of hope and divine grace, of ceaseless and endless mercy, we ask that you soothe our minds and steady our resolve. Bring forth your peace. Bring forth your blessings. Strengthen our lives and inspire our spirits for the next 2 days. Fill us with your peace so we catch the winds of hope. Bless this day. Bless these people. Bless this occasion. and bless our families and our children. Let us go forth in peace, but we ask and we petition that you give us your eyes that we have your vision. Give us your ears that we may have empathy. Give us your heart so we may have compassion. May we speak the language of hope. May we go forth without fear to tackle the challenges and rigors of a digital Pacifica. All this we pray in and through the name of our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Whaftai lama.
Manatu o lele ua mai ona fusifusi la au ma molimoli fonga. Le foi ua uma ona whana le ule vāte tea. Tā foi le taa mute vāo wāla tātou vāta pui ma le tātou tapa au ili lang. Pe ona veai le sunga ili whawhia ngainga fomai, sunga si osi sa le solu e fai mo tātou wosi tau langa. O la mātou te talo, le atua pulpulitite le utu pupu ina fulo le senga ula. Ia uwa le whia ngaiai ma le whia au ma le tala lei. Maua lau launga, ia, tele ni anganga, ia, e whaima apa au o le tāla le leit tono le nuu malea fio anga. Thank you, Reverend Dr. Siosi Salesulu, for sharing the word of God and also the opening prayer. May our Heavenly Father continues to bless you and anoint you for his calling. Ia, e manatu o le loma loma ta aua le nei, e tu ina atuai le avanoa le saunoanga, au tu o le nei aso, ile afionga ile matua ole usuali le sa faialanga matematea malo ya ole minsta so fantasi ole tato national ICT committee o ia fo ole minsta so ta inga ma fa matalanga teknolosi le afionga ya afamsanga le pu ya e fonuti riko tupai. May I now invite the Honorable Afamsanga for his keynote speech. Honorable Afamsanga is the youngest and the good looking minister of cabinet. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the Minister of Communications and Information Technology.
Thank you, Mr. MC. You did very well until that last part. Reverend Dr. Siosi Salesulu, Honorable Acting Prime Minister of Yonga Tialavea, John Siohant, Honourable Minister of Finance, Lau Fionga Sili Epa, Honourable Deputy Prime Minister of Tuvalu, Lau Fionga Matatia Tofa, Titular Head of Tokelau, Honourable Fenga Ngawolofa, Mr. Hao Liang Su, the Assistant Secretary of the UNDP Regional Bureau for Asia and Pacific, Ms. Simona, the UN Resident Coordinator in Samoa, members of the Diplomatic Corps, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen. A heartfelt thanks, Pacific thank you to you all for coming to visit us all. And I would like to welcome you all to the inaugural regional conference together for Pacific, Digital Pacific 2018. I look around and recognize that some of you have traveled a long way, and I hope along the way you got an airline upgrade. For those of you who didn't, I tell you that should you have traveled Samoa Airways, every seat on that plane would have felt like an upgrade. We're very happy to have you with us over the coming days in a sunny Apia to discuss such an important issue for our region. On behalf of the government of Samoa, I would like to extend a special thank you to the UNDP for partnership and partnering with us to host this meeting. We thank the Assistant Secretary General, Mr. Su, for his commitment and presence here today. the UN Resident Coordinator, Ms. Simona Mirinescu, and her team at UNDP for their support, without which this conference wouldn't have been possible. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, the next 2 days are an important opportunity to exchange views and share experiences about the digitalization of our governments and economies and how this can contribute to our people's prosperity and our country's sustainable development. As we all know, as Pacific small island developing states, from the largest to the smallest, we face a common but unique set of developmental challenges. Our small size and narrow resource and export base, exposure to global environmental challenges and external economic shocks, our vulnerability to adverse impacts of climate change, remoteness from most large markets, and reliance on remittances. Many of these challenges were highlighted in the outcome of the SIDS conference held in Samoa 2014, the Samoa Pathway. The outcome has recognized the importance of information and communication technologies in ensuring the economic sustainability of us as small island developing states. The international community has reaffirmed its commitment to support SIDS to gain access and to increase connectivity and the use of ICT through improved infrastructure, training and national legislation, as well as public and private sector involvement. Therefore, the discussion this week and the outcome of our deliberations are timely. Given the Pacific SIDS regional meeting to review the Samoa pathway will be held in the next few weeks in Tonga. Digital transformation is key to the implementation of the Samoa pathway and in achieving our sustainable development goals. By working together on regionally relevant digital initiatives, built on timely exchanges of information and cooperation, we can overcome to a degree our challenges as small island states. Through enhanced international fiber-based internet connectivity, we can bring markets nearer to our island shores, connect our sellers to the world, and reduce the high operating costs for our governments and businesses through telecommuting and online delivery of education and access to training. As of February this year, with the landing of our new Tui Samoa submarine fiber optic trunk, our national internet bandwidth capacity has in one jump expanded some 800-fold. And that is just the start of things to come. Samoa is no longer and will never be as remote as it once was. And we are excited to be able to share our vision for a digital Pacific with you. The next 2 days, we will first have practitioner experts from countries well recognized as digital transformation pioneers to showcase their experiences with us. Australia, Estonia, South Korea, New Zealand, and Singapore. I am positive we will all learn from their achievements. Second, we will host panel discussions covering topics of leadership, change management, innovation, emerging job opportunities, and workforce upskilling on the digitalization pathway. We will also discuss the cost, efficiency, effectiveness, and the unexpected consequences of culture and social cohesion factors involved with digitalization. Third, we have set up an exhibition area for you to explore, bringing together different solution providers, both local and international, to showcase their technology and answer questions you may have relating to private and public sector digital transformation. Tomorrow, we will have time to recap key insights and undertake a visioning exercise to identify key aspects of our digital future together. Simultaneously, some of our best young minds will be working in a parallel event to envision a digital future for 2030. From their unique perspective, I continue to be inspired by the innovation and determination of our young minds in the private and public sectors, and look forward to the presentation at the end of that session. Finally, we will host a roundtable dialogue describing our ICT sector and future needs here in Samoa. And we aim to link this conversation to the upcoming meeting in Tonga. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I thank you once again for joining this important meeting. I welcome you all once again, and we look forward to taking these important steps together for a digital Pacific. So if you are my man, we are.
Ia manatua lele ua mai apapanga ma mena mena I tafua le ananea. Ia masao le aofia, e tusai o le malelenga ma le sao noanga, alana fionga I le main star. On that same spirit, I would also like to invite Mr. Hao Liang Xu for his keynote address. Mr. Hao Liang Xu is the UN Assistant Secretary and Director for the UNDP Regional Bureau for Asia and Pacific. Mr. Xu.
Thank you very much. Reverend Minister, Dr. Siaosi Sule Solo, Honorable Acting Prime Minister, and Honorable Members of Cabinet, Your Excellency Ulu of Tokelau, and Honorable Ministers of Information and Communication Technology of the Pacific and their distinguished representatives, Honorable Deputy Prime Minister of Tuvalu, Honorable Members of Parliament, and members of the Diplomatic Corps and representatives of the regional organizations in the Pacific, Chief Executive Offices of Government Ministries, and representatives of the private sector, and representatives of the civil society, members of the media, and the colleagues, heads of UN agencies, and the UN colleagues. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of UNDP and other co-organizers of this conference, I would like to sincerely thank the government of Samoa for organizing the inaugural Together for a Digital Pacific Conference and for the opportunity to address this very distinguished audience. I would like to commend the government's leadership to foster the discussion of this important subject and the sharing of knowledge, and also for fostering opportunities for regional cooperation. As I arrived last night, Minister, not having the benefit of the upgrade after 30 hours of travel, you know, in economy class, in fact. So I look forward to an upgrade in Air Samoa. But as I arrived, I just started to receive emails. Right, as you connect, you know, switch the safe mode, you know. And in a village on the way to Apia, right, you started to realize that the 4G connection is everywhere. And I was thinking how I can, I was calculating the time difference to think how I can contact my son, 12-year-old son in New York, to make sure that he doesn't waste his time, you know, in doing homework and so forth. So I think I really just realized that the technology is already here, right? And the question is, who is using it? Who is benefiting from it? And last year, we did a megatrends analysis with the Economist Intelligence Unit on what affects development in Asia Pacific. The five megatrends stand out. One is the shift of geopolitical balances that are taking place in the world, where the center of gravity is shifting towards Asia. Right? Because today, Asia-Pacific accounts for 40% of the world's output. So the world is changing. That is affecting the development in Asia-Pacific. And the second one, not in order of importance, is climate change. But definitely, climate change came as one of the top concerns for Asia-Pacific. Right. And I don't need to elaborate more on how climate change is affecting small island states in the Pacific. But it affects other countries equally, including mega cities in Asia-Pacific and agriculture everywhere. Right. The third one you can say is inequality, the rising inequality. Right. As the wealth continues to increase, but inequality between rich and the poor, between rich and countries and poor countries, rich regions and the poor regions of a country, between rural and urban areas, between genders and so forth, right, are rising. And that will be a source of instability, to say the least. Right. And the fourth one that was identified is the rapid urbanization that are taking place in Asia Pacific. In the next few years until 2030, I believe 200 million people in Asia-Pacific will move to urban. And this year is a watershed year in that Asia-Pacific as a whole region will be 50-50 between urban and rural population. Right. So the change, the pace of change is rapid. And the fifth one, not necessarily the least important one, is the advancement of technology. The industrial 4.0, industrial revolution 4.0, and related use of technology. Right. So I think the technological change is affecting us already. It is here today, right? And we have many examples how technology has had transformative impact on development in Asia Pacific, right? As the acting prime minister rightly said, increased the connectivity is a phenomenon that is being replicated across the Pacific and the world. And new technology and ICT infrastructure are making possible the impossible possible in a way, like overcoming the tyranny of distance, literally, right? And opening up new opportunities for employment, governance, disaster risk management and combating climate change and so forth. And we have examples from a number of countries in the Asia and the Pacific region, right, on how this use of technology has transformed lives. There's a well-known project in the Pacific. It's co-funded by the Australian government and the European Union, and also supported by both UNCDF, the UN Capital Development Fund, and the UNDP in the Pacific. It's called the Pacific Financial Inclusion Program. Over the last 10 years, with the support of our partner countries, right, and also private sector companies, the banks, right, the digital cell phone providers, okay, and of course our governments, the central banks, working in Fiji, Papua New Guinea, Samoa, Solomon Islands, Tonga, and Vanuatu, right, we have brought 2 million people, unbanked people in remote areas, to modern banking, to modern financial services. Right. So this is a significant example of using technologies to benefit the marginalized, right, in the remote areas. I also visited Bhutan, at least the developed countries in South Asia, where distance will force the MPs, the members of parliament, to drive for days, if not weeks, to reach their constituencies. So using internet and the teleconference technology, we have now set up a virtual dialogue system for members of parliament to contact their constituency any time of the day, and 360 days a year. And in Bangladesh, we have access to digital service, access to information project that has reached the whole of the country, and no citizen needs to travel for more than 4 kilometers to get digitized government service, more than 100 kinds of digital services, saving billions of dollars in time and in cost for every ordinary citizen. So we have many examples, and this can happen in the Pacific, and can happen in Pacific everywhere. So, if I may return to what I started earlier, you know, who is benefiting from this technology? Right? So the question is that are the villages living in the villages that I passed equally benefiting as we do, right, from this technology? As technology changes the way citizens, governments, and the business interact, we need to make sure that this progress does not increase the digital divide between the urban and the rural, and between the rich and the poor, or between the developed and the developing nations of the world. We need an inclusive digital future for the Pacific, and bearing in mind that the islands in the Pacific are some of the most vulnerable and remote countries in the world, this cannot be underscored enough. Our commitment to the Sustainable Development Goals, to the Agenda 2030, and to the Samoa pathway must be unwavering and will require gigantic leaps into uncharted spaces and find the presently unknown solutions, and will require governments and businesses to partner together to innovate, to find innovative ways like never before. We're already running out of time. We have 12 years of the 15 years left to achieve the SDGs. Therefore, I'm happy that this meeting is taking place today. Okay. And I'm happy to see that we have many partners from the government as well as from the private sector and the civil society here. Okay. When governments understand the needs of the private sector, and when the private sector understands the development priorities of the government, of the countries, everyone stands to benefit. I think we understand the importance of the technology. Right? What we need is a mindset change, right? And how we can see this technology not as a threat but as an opportunity. There are issues as I read the background materials about Samoa and the Pacific. Right? We have many new challenges. The technology is bringing already huge impact to societies elsewhere, with unforeseen societies, changes, impacts that the societies are not well prepared to deal with. Right. If the internet bandwidth is going to increase significantly, people's access to information will increase also significantly. So we need to think about how young people will be able to access information, what kind of information they will access, and how they will process the information they access. Right? How governments can reach the population, right? And how citizens can give feedback to the government. Right? So many questions will require us to think and to prepare for them. Right? How will the media play a role in the future? Right? So I'm very happy that this is an opportunity where over the next 2 years, we can learn examples of several countries and how over the last few decades they have advanced the use of technology for good government, right, to benefit the citizens. And I come back to Reverend Minister said, I think he said it extremely fittingly, that is the technology after all is about empowering people. Right? So we want the citizens, ordinary citizens, to benefit from this technology, and ultimately we work together to improve people's lives and achieve the leaving no one behind the purpose of the 2030 agenda. So with this, I thank you very much for your attention. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Xu. Our next and last keynote speaker for this morning is Professor Jeffrey Sachs. Professor Sachs is unable to join us in this room. However, thanks to technology, he was able to record his address digitally for us all. Jeffrey Sachs is a famous professor of economics, an author, and leader in sustainable development, and has twice been named among Time Magazine's 100 most influential world leaders. His work in environmental leadership has also won him awards, and we are privileged to have him address our conference. Please, can we have his video to address us all? Thank you.